Now, moving on to the anti-terror law, what are your thoughts on the new AFP chief, Lieutenant General Gilbert Gapay, who, well, many thought started on the wrong foot by suggesting that social media be covered by the Anti-Terror Act?
Yeah, I also talked to him, Karen, ano? Sabi ko, ano bang ibig mong sabihin dyan? And sabi niya, hindi naman yung, I think sabi niya, kulang yung explanation ko. Sabi niya, I'm not apologizing for him, but this is how he explained it to me. Sabi niya, ang tinutukoy pala niya, yung darknet. There is a darknet kasi this is a alternative website for the underground economy, yung mga illegal sale of drugs, weapons, trafficking of people. Doon yan, yung darknet. Back, I read about darknet also. And it is there. Kaya lang hindi natin makita-kita. No? Now, how can you regulate something that is underground and it is not actually legit? Ngayon, the other night, sabi naman niya nung in-interview siya, is that what he wants to be regulated is the platform, not not the users. So I don't know, but to me, I don't think we should regulate the social media, Karen. To me, it's a very good vehicle for people to air their grievances and everything.
Okay. Now, when it comes to the implementing rules and regulations of the Anti-Terror Act, what do you think should be included in it for it to be implemented effectively against suspected terrorists? Ano po ang gusto niyong masali sa IRR?
As of now, Karen, I have not seen the draft. Ano? The DOJ is making the draft. And according to Secretary Guevara, after it is finished, the draft is finished, ay ipapakita sa amin, ako, si Secretary Anyo, Secretary Spiron, and I think Nika. Tingnan natin kung ano pang pwedeng ilagdag. But as of now, I will decline commenting because hindi ko pa nakikita yung IRR nila na draft. Mm-hmm.
Ano ba ang pagkakaintindi niyo, Secretary Lorenzana, sa Section 29 of the Anti-Terror Act? There are over 26 petitions already in the Supreme Court questioning the constitutionality of the Anti-Terror Act. Yet Section 29 is the most contentious.
Yeah, we'll give it to the Supreme Court, Karen, to decide that. No? I'm not a lawyer. I don't know about these things. So there are already how many 25 petitioners questioning the 29 Section 29. We'll let the Supreme Court decide. Kasi sabi naman, it's in their court now. The ball is in their hands. So let them do their jobs also.
Okay. But then you spoke with Lieutenant General Gilbert Gapay. Did you recommend him to the President to be AFP chief?
Actually, Karen, we recommended 6 names. Because we give the President the choice kung sino ang all qualified. So he chose General Gapay. So it's him. Pero okay, hindi kami nag-recommend ng isang tao lang. At least three. At least three.
Okay. And what advice did you give him when you last spoke? I mean, especially with that misstep on SOCMED being regulated. What advice did you give the new AFP chief?
Well, to be very discerning about his action, yung answers niya, no. Sabi ko sa kanya, if you are not sure of your answer, then do not answer. Sabi mo, I'll find out or I research the correct answer.
Oo. Okay.
Less talk, less mistake.
Less talk, less mistake.